Hello, it's time for Faith and Friends. Thanks for being with us. We look forward to spending the next 30 minutes with you. We're welcoming the month of May this week. It's time for graduation parties, gardens, and spring cleaning, which means auction donations. TV44 is now accepting your auction donations. Call 419-339-4444 for more information, or simply bring your items to TV44 Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Let's jump right into today's show, which will include a look back into a very important April event, Easter. That holiday may be weeks past, but the message of Easter remains. We'll take you to some recent local events honoring our risen King Jesus. Also today, we take a look, our final look, at the 2016 Faith Challenge step of forgiving others. That's the final look for that step. We've got several more steps to come this year as Pastor Doug Boquist joins us in the studio.
Looking forward to that conversation, but let's jump into our May Faith Challenge step, hearing the voice of God. How do you hear God's voice and know how to proceed? One way is through Scripture. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verses 1 through 6 says, "Now it shall come to pass, if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God, to observe carefully all his commandments, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the earth. And all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you, because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Blessed shall you be in the city, and blessed shall you be in the country. Blessed shall you be the fruit of your body, the produce of your ground, and the increase of your herds, the increase of your cattle, and the offspring of your flocks. Blessed shall be your basket and your kneading bowl. Blessed shall you be when you come in, and blessed shall you be when you go out." There is no question that when we're following God, when we're obeying his commandments, that our life is closer to him. It doesn't mean that we're going to get everything we ask for and we're going to live this super abundant life, material possession wise, but it certainly means he is with us and his favor rests upon us.
Absolutely.
Well, Easter and the resurrection of Jesus was celebrated in mid-April. Now, even though the egg hunts and special dinners are now long in the past, their message still remains. Jennifer takes a look at how some area churches and businesses used Easter as a way to positively impact others and what you can be doing today to continue that message. Here's this week's OIO in the community segment.
Easter, it happens once a year. Pretty dresses, candy, eggs. But is that really Easter? Every year, the Resurrection Holiday Celebration is an opportunity for local churches and faith-based business owners to share the life-changing message of forgiveness and freedom with those in the region. And even though those egg hunts and dinners have passed, the forgiveness message remains strong. Perhaps those who attended the Tomall family Easter dinner April 16th are still impacted by what they were given.
Well, they get a tract first about Christ, then they get ham, mashed potatoes, green beans, bread, dessert, and cookies and drinks. Hoping to share the love of Christ, that's why we're here. That's what.
Absolutely. Yeah. And we've talked about it to our helpers as well, that we are here to serve, and let's serve today.
Serving the community. At this event, it came in the form of meals, greetings, and an opportunity to give back to others. Around 50 individuals from the community came together to put on this annual dinner. Hosted by the Ellis family for 25 years, the All family gladly accepted the torch to lead up this important community event. Service. It's something the All family knows well and comes easily from their hearts. That heart for service was also evident Easter weekend at Grace Fellowship Church. From a meal to a gospel message, gift of food, egg hunt, and outdoor fun. Church members smiled with delight, knowing they were providing something far more lasting than an Easter basket. The message of the empty tomb is one that lives on forever, a sentiment also shared at Calvary Chapel of Praise.
He didn't stay in that tomb. He rose from the grave, and he brought life, and he brings life, and we want to show them that Jesus is life.
The Big Egg Hunt is an annual Calvary Church project, and community members have come to know this church's heart for others. While many in attendance walked away with tangible items like a bike, Chuck E. Cheese tickets, candy, and prizes, the overall hope is that they will also walk away with something more.
We're loving on the community and show them the real reason that Jesus came. He came to die and give his life so that we could be free. And so he loved on everyone. Everywhere he went, he healed, he set free, he loved on them. He made sure they were taken care of, and that's what we just want to love on the community.
So what now? Easter is done. The eggs have disappeared. Life is back to normal. But what is normal? For many, service is normal. Giving back is rewarding. And living with the reality that Jesus' resurrection means life eternal and forgiveness for all. Pray for all who attended not only these events, but other Easter events, that the message of the resurrection would continue to have an impact on their daily lives.
All throughout April, our spiritual workout step has been forgiving others. Before we move on to step five, we're going to ponder that important topic of forgiving others one more week. And today we welcome in Pastor Doug Boquist from Lima Community Church. Thanks for being with us today.
It's a pleasure, Andy.
Forgiveness, such a huge thing. We could delve into it, but maybe one of the good ways to know how we're doing in this area is what it is not.
Exactly. I think if we clarify what it isn't, it helps us understand what it is. Years ago, a lady called me to come out to her house. Wonderful saint. She was dying, and she said, I'm afraid to die. I said, really? She said, yeah. She said, I'm afraid I haven't forgiven somebody. I said, really? And she told me the story, and I said, well, okay, let me ask you a question. If his house burnt down, would you be excited? She said, no, that'd be terrible. Okay. If he got a terrible cancer, would that make you excited? No. No, that'd be, I'd be very sad for him. I said, so you wish him well? She said, yeah. I said, you have forgiven him. She said, I have? I said, yeah. I said, you can still feel bad about what happened and forgive. You can still feel sad and still have forgiven. There are times when anger can still arise and still have forgiven. The key component is, can you bless that person? Have you surrendered your right to take revenge? I remember to this day how quickly tears shot out of her eyes. She said, I'm ready to go. I said, yeah. She said, yeah, you're ready to go.
Wow. Yeah. It's amazing how forgiveness frees us. Jesus did it for many reasons, but it's for us.
Well, yeah. And I'm afraid sometimes some people are so sensitive that they're afraid they haven't forgiven when they really, really, really have. I'll give you another case in point. Sometimes people think that when you forgive somebody, you, out of necessity, have to go right back into the same kind of relationship that it was before. Yeah. Well, not necessarily so. You know, if you've been wounded a number of times by this person, forgiveness doesn't mean you have to put yourself in harm's way again. It means if you can bless them, you wish them well.
Yeah, I like that. And a lot of times, it's a relationship where you can't go face to face and talk to them. You have to forgive them from afar.
Right.
And you don't feel good about that because you want to have that face-to-face interaction. If you can, by all means, do it.
Right.
But sometimes there needs to be that space.
Well, and sometimes the other person is deceased. Right. And sometimes it's a mutual conflict and both parties have to ask forgiveness and give forgiveness. And so one person says, I'm trying to make up with them, but they won't forgive me and I'm trying. Well, whether that person forgives you or not doesn't mean you're still on the hook. Romans 12:18 says, inasmuch as it depends on you, live at peace with all people. I can't control what somebody else is going to do. I can control my heart. And if my heart does not harbor the intent for revenge, if I can bless that person, that's forgiveness.
And then how important is it to live a lifestyle of forgiveness where even just the smallest of offenses, you're taken care of right away?
Well, what a lot of people don't understand is if you have one area of bitterness, that you can't isolate it to that one relationship. Unforgiveness is a cancer. It just eats at you. And in time begins to infect other relationships. When we understand how much we've been forgiven. You know, the story of the unmerciful servant who was forgiven this huge boatload of debt and then goes out and chokes somebody for $1.75. Well, the only way I can understand that is that guy didn't understand the extent of his sin and how grievous it was and how much he was forgiven. If he totally understood, there's no way he would choke somebody for $1.75. And so, people who struggle forgiving others, I think, need to do a gut check to realize how much they've been forgiven.
We read that story and we say, oh, it's so obvious.
Yeah.
But so many times We're blind to our own sins.
Well, that's right. Yeah. That's right.
Pastor Doug Boquist from Lima Community Church joining us here talking about forgiving others. And as we mature as Christians, is it a process of becoming more forgiving, or doesn't that have a correlation?
Well, I think there is a process. I think it's a process even with one episode. When you say somebody's really hurt you, there are some people who think you need to forgive and it's over and done, and we do. But sometimes it's a process. Yeah. I've seen a lot of people who haven't really forgiven somebody, but kind of whitewash over it, and they stitch up a wound, but inside the wound, there's still some infection, and then it fosters. So what I tell people is what motion are you going in? How are you progressing here? And there's some relationships where you can't avoid being together, and there is, kind of a continual, upbraiding, and you have to come back to it and surrender again and forgive. One of the things, every once in a while I run into somebody that has been terribly mistreated, and it just tragically so, and they say, I don't want to forgive them. They deserve to be unforgiven, and I say two things. Number one is unforgiveness is like hoping that other person dies while you drink the poison.
Oh, yeah.
The other thing is I tell them the place to start is this prayer. I want to forgive.
Yeah.
Even if you don't want to, say, Lord, I want to obey you. I want to forgive. Years ago, I met a guy who was a POW in Korea, and it was 20 years after that. And I took him out to coffee. I was speaking in his church. And he said, I can't forgive my captors. And he said, I don't sleep at night. I dream about taking a shovel. And he had this vivid thing that he wanted to do. And when he was all done with, it was kind of a rant. I said, well, John, you're still a prisoner. You're as imprisoned in your spirit as your body was in Korea. Unforgiveness is... we forgive them as much as a favor to ourselves. It frees us.
Yeah, it definitely does. Well, if this conversation has brought about some feelings right now, and there's someone you need to forgive, I really encourage you to pray that prayer. I want to forgive that person. And take the step now, whether it's a text message, setting up a conversation, a date for lunch, something. Take that step, because it will free you. Mark Kuntz joins us now. Mark.
Thank you, Andy. Now, as the month of May progresses, you'll hear more about our fifth spiritual workout step, hearing the voice of God. April showers, May bring May flowers, and all the months of spring bring spring cleaning. Now is a great time to go through your garage, shed, or anywhere throughout your house and bring your items to TV 44. We're ready to accept your good quality furniture, antiques, collectibles, and garage and boutique items. Now, if you're considering buying a different car, you can donate your current car to TV 44. All donations are eligible for a tax deduction, and your donations are used to further the mission of TV 44. Bring your donations to our offices at 1844 Beatty Road, Lima, Ohio, Monday through Thursday from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m., or call 419-339-4444 for more information. Donating to the TV 44 auction is just another way to partner with our ministry as we desire to reach the region for Christ. Now to today's health topic. It's part four of our series, Fully Alive with Donna Kresh. Last week, the topic was hot flashes and night sweats. This week's topic, you're doing everything right, but you still can't lose weight. Does that describe you? Well, here's Jennifer with part four of Fully Alive.
I want you to take a moment to think about your health journey. Are you dealing with some weight issues? You just can't figure out how to get rid of them. You've tried diets, you've tried exercise, you've tried everything that seems to be the right thing to do, yet you still cannot lose weight. Well, is there another issue that if you get on top of that issue, then all of a sudden it's all gonna fall into place? Donna Kretsch joins us again this week as we continue our talk about adrenal issues and stress and cortisol. And now we're gonna talk about weight, because in the end, they all fit together.
Boy, don't they. I used to say to my husband, I really hate weight loss. And you know, we'd be like out to dinner and he'd be like, don't say that. People are going to think like you're a fraud or something. And I learned to say I hate just weight loss because people gain their weight back. 97%, as a matter of fact, is the stat on people that gain their weight back. And I couldn't do it anymore. I told my staff I was quitting. I literally said, I'm walking out. I can't do this anymore. I have to know we're giving somebody a foolproof lifestyle solution so they can be fully alive. And I thought that we were, but the lifestyle piece we were teaching was too cumbersome, and now it's simpler. So as we started doing research with all the hormone experts we've been talking about, I found out that there are three trends for people over 35, and it's common. It's common for people over 35. Either you used to be able to lose weight without any problem at all, and now you cannot lose weight no matter what you do. Or you can lose some, but then you get stuck. You can't lose anymore. You're doing everything right. Or, again, this is for people over 35, right? You never really even had weight to lose. But now all of a sudden, you've got this unexplained weight gain. You're eating right. You're exercising correctly. You can, and it just keeps building. And kind of freaky. So like, what? I don't know what's going on. Those are three very common trends. And health symptoms that we're now dealing with because of Saley response, like we talked about on our last episode, are making it impossible to lose weight, which because hormones are becoming more imbalanced, it all just comes back to this hormone imbalance that's occurring because we're over 35. So we're addressing that. And in addressing it, folks like Linda have lost weight and are keeping the weight off, but you've tried a lot of other things before.
Yes,
sitting
have.
Down with us. Can you give us some examples of what you tried before?
Jenny Craig, Weight Watchers, Body for Life.
So you've done it all. So the question on everybody's mind, if we're totally transparent, is what makes you think this one's any different? Did you lose weight with those others?
No.
So you didn't even lose with those. How much have you lost with this?
30 pounds. And she
okay.
did the 20-30 fast
She did 20-30 and went on to listen to your body,
yes.
right, which is a lifestyle option. So Linda, tell me, why do you think this one's different? Because you're saying, look, I tried everything else and I couldn't lose, but I lost with this. Why do you think that was?
Getting my hormones back down to baseline, and I didn't realize how my hormones affected me.
Oh, yeah, most people don't. People don't talk
no.
about it, right? So you started paying attention to how the stress, right, threw the hormones off. You started learning that is what
yes.
you're saying. So then started paying attention to how the symptoms and how that manifested or showed up
right.
in your body. So now you are gorgeous. I told her I expected her to show up in a ball gown because she's fallen in love with ball gowns. And she puts them on Facebook all the time and she's absolutely stunning.
Thank you.
And I said, I can't believe you're not showing up in a ball gown today. What are you, help us understand, I mean, you lost it and that's awesome because you couldn't lose it with these other right. programs. But now we were talking about what makes this listen to your body thing different. You actually gave me an example the other night.
Yeah.
You had something happen. Can you tell us what that was?
My bottom lip swelled up and part of my jaw swelled up. Something that I ate affected me.
So the biggest thing you're learning is something that I ate affected that symptom.
Yes.
And that's really the main thing. Now, here's the really cool thing about how God made our bodies. Understanding that when you put a food into your body is either going to receive it or it's going to stress it. Okay, and again, there are very few foods that stress most of us. But if that does occur, there will be a symptom. There's always a why behind a symptom. And I think the most exciting thing for me is if we can help our member understand there's a why behind any symptom. And so Linda's saying she had a lower lip swell up and immediately said there's a why behind this
yes.
symptom, right? It's throwing my hormones off and started investigating. We were talking
right.
about she started thinking about what she'd just eaten. Now again, stress can be physiological from a food. It can be mental or emotional. If I deal with an exceptionally high mentally stressful day, my sleep's affected. I mean, it's not usually a food or a drink with me
mm-hmm.
as much as that mental stress will spike my cortisol like crazy and my sleep is affected. But it can be anything. So you went back to, okay, what was the stressor, which may have been the food.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
and here's the magical thing, like I started to say, God made our bodies so miraculously that if we pay attention to the fact there's a why behind every symptom, and we will go back to what that why was, the symptoms stop showing up, and we literally will never need to lose weight again for the rest of our life. So now, me, who used to say, oh, just weight loss, now I'm like, I can build happy, healthy, fully alive people because I can teach them. There's a why behind every symptom. And if you pay attention to that why, which is stress, okay, again, physiological or mental or emotional, if you pay attention to that symptom and the stress behind it, you can keep the symptoms away forever, but you will literally never, ever, ever gain the weight back. Mm-hmm. So if you pay attention to the symptoms when they show up and know there's a why behind it, the weight's never going to come back because you go back to paying attention to the food.
Linda, are you feeling more fully alive?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I'm so happy. I can face the day knowing that I'm looking my best.
Not just on the outside.
On the
but
inside.
But that's an example of what you're inside. Having on the inside as well.
I feel healthy. I'm knowing my body now where I didn't know it before.
Excellent. Excellent. That is what God intends. He does intend for us to live fully alive. That is His desire. Maybe this conversation is spurring on thoughts in your mind. Maybe you feel like you have experienced some of the same things Linda has experienced. Well, if you'd like to find out more information, or if you want to connect with Donna Crutch or those that she work with her, here are the ways that you can find out more information. There's the phone number on your screen. It's easy to go to the website, 2030fasttrack.com, and their location is right there, 709 North Cable Road, Lima, Ohio, 45805. God truly has designed you to live fully alive. Sometimes it takes us a little while to get over the hurdle so that we can reach that, but God will be right there with you, holding your hand, carrying you through it, so that you can live your life, the remainder of your days, exactly the way God had intended.
The Spring to Life Spring Funding Campaign continues, and there are three great ways to be a part of this funding campaign. Number one, pray. Commit to pray for TV44 daily that God would supply our financial needs and work on the hearts of those who are in a position to give.
Number two, you can give. Your financial support will push TV44 into the summer months, a time when financial donations often decrease significantly. Now, some have already joined the campaign, include the Karchers in Columbus Grove, the Tracys in Lima, and the Wreckers from Ottawa. Thank you very much. Number three on our list of things you can do, encourage your church, your Sunday school group, or your extended family to come together to make a one-time donation to the Spring to Life campaign. When you donate to TV44, you're supporting family-friendly programming, biblically sound preaching and teaching, and a positive impact with youth in our community. Donate online at WTLW.com or by phone at 419-339-4444, or you can donate in person or by mail at 1844 Beatty Road, Lima, Ohio, 45807.
Maybe you consider TV44 a source to strengthen your marriage. Well, up next is part two in Jennifer's conversation with David and Tracy Sellers of VowsToKeep.com Marriage Ministries. This is becoming a champion for your spouse's causes.
I think we can never go wrong if it's not a simple pursuit, if it's something else, by taking up our spouse's cause. God's going to show you great reward in that. And it might be a long time before you see the investment. It might not be right away that you see your spouse coming around and coming on board with what you want, or even teaming up together, especially to get on board with what God wants for your marriage. It might be 2 years or 2 months or who knows how long. God knows though, and He encourages us in His word to be faithful. It says in 1 Corinthians 15:58, to always give ourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because we know that our labor in the Lord is not in vain. And when we're taking up our spouse's cause, we're laboring in the Lord, and we can rely on His promises. It's a very powerful way for our spouse to experience the love of God, whether they're a Christian or not, when we love on them in this way. And it's also a powerful way for us to imitate our Savior, because we need to remember that the gospel is at the heart of this. We have a Savior, we have a champion who took up our cause when we least deserved it. And I'm so grateful for that.
Donate your car, boat, motorcycle, or mower to the TV44 auction. You'll benefit from a tax deduction, but more importantly, you'll be part of the ministry of TV44. Call today to find out more.
One more reminder, donations are being accepted now for the 2017 TV44 auction. We're talking about furniture, tools, cars, mowers, antiques, collectibles, boutique, and a garage sale items. You can bring those items to TV44 Monday through Thursday, anytime between 10 a.m. and at 3 p.m. on those 4 days of the week.
And also, our current drawing for 2 season tickets to the Lima Area Concert Band remains open. We will draw our winners at the end of this week. Visit faithandfriends.wtlw.com to enter or call the station and request your name and phone number to be added to the drawing.
Now, one more look at our scripture verse from Deuteronomy chapter 28, verses 1 through 6. Now it shall come to pass, if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God to observe carefully all his commandments, which I commanded you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the earth, and all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Blessed shall be in the city, and blessed shall you be in the country. Blessed shall be the fruit of your body, the produce of your ground, and the increase of your herds, the increase of your cattle, and the offspring of your flocks. Blessed shall be your basket and your kneading bowl. Blessed shall you be when you come in, and blessed shall you be when you go out. We certainly pray that that's encouragement to you to follow closely to the Lord our God and to listen to his voice through scripture, through prayer, and through those around us. Have a great day.